In this video, you will learn how to set up and run Kubernetes on your Mac without the need for any cloud service such as GCP or AWS. Although this guide is only for your Mac, you can set up Kubernetes on any other computer by following similar steps. Before diving into this guide, it's better to understand why you may need to set up and run Kubernetes on your local Mac. You may need to run Kubernetes on your local to learn Kubernetes or test your application before deploying on the cloud. This is also a good option to avoid charges of cloud services and get hands-on experience of all the features of Kubernetes. This guide is divided into 10 steps. By the end of this video, you should be able to run your first container in the Kubernetes on your local Mac. Step 1. Download and install Docker on your Mac. You can download and install Docker Desktop from the link given in the description of this video. After installing Docker, you need to start it. Step 2. Install Hyperkit. Hyperkit is required by Minikube to create containers. To install Hyperkit, run the following command. This command use brew. If you already don't have brew on your Mac, you can install brew first and then run the command. Step 3. Install Minikube. Minikube is the main tool that is used to run and manage Kubernetes on local. To install Minikube, run the following two commands. The first command downloads the Minikube, and the second command install the Minikube on your Mac. Step 4. Start Minikube. Run the following command to run Minikube on your local. Make sure to specify the driver as Hyperkit. On the completion of this step, Minikube will start a Kubernetes cluster on your Mac. Now, the Kubernetes is up and running on your Mac. Step 5. Create a namespace in your cluster to deploy your application. Run the following command to create a namespace on your newly created Kubernetes cluster. I will create a namespace, dev-space, in this video and use the same throughout this video. You may change this name. Step 6. Now you can deploy your first container on Kubernetes. To deploy your first container, clone this sample repository on your Mac. The link of this repository is given in the description. Step 7. Open a terminal and go to the root folder of this codebase that was cloned in the previous step and run the following commands. The first command is only required for Minikube and not required if you build your Docker image for production. The second command will build a Docker image that will be used to deploy your container in the Kubernetes. Step 8. Create deployment and the service in the Kubernetes for the sample application that you have prepared in the last step. Run the following commands. The first command creates a deployment and the second command creates the service. Make sure to specify your correct namespace. Step 9. In the previous step, you have created a deployment and service. Now your app is running. Run the following command to see your app. This command will open your application in the browser. In this step, you have finished the deployment of your application in the Kubernetes cluster. Step 10. After finishing the setup of your Kubernetes clusters with Minikube and creating deployment and services, you may need to interact with your cluster to view deployment, pod, or services. You can run the following commands. The first command gives you the list of the deployments in your application namespace. The second command is for services, and the third command can be used to view pods.